So if you remember, this is one of the very first packages we installed right at the very beginning. And the reason I'm going to install it now is for the dependencies. I would have thought that most of these we didn't have. Things like this HTTP daemon, that's what we've just done a little while back for lib, was it Biber, I think it was, which had maybe about 100 or more Perl modules. That's one of the Perl modules, so that we've just done that. IOSocket SSL the same. I'm going to have to check some of these, like this libidn and libpsl. I think they'd be in. Let me just check this GNU TLS. I'm not sure if that one I've got. Yes, I've got that to rebuild actually. So maybe we can do that one as well. So let's pull these all in. Now I've got that one. Now I've got that one. Let's check libidn, libpsl. Now I've got PCRE and got PCRE2 and got Valgrind, so I don't need to look any further. Let's look at PSL needs libidn2, so let's move that around. We've got all of these, so let's just check libidn2 is installed. Oh, there's a command there, so we can just try and run it. Libidn2, yeah. So that's obviously in. And not sure if we installed it with let's have a look at this documentation. Not sure if that exists or not, if we have built it after GTK doc. Yes, we have. So that doesn't need to be done. Let's check PSL. Feeling this has been done as well, you know. It's traveling PSL. Yep, that's there. So we don't need to do that. So basically, what we need to do is to rebuild GNU TLS. Alright, there's a few dependencies here. So, Doxygen, we've got. Oh, let's start at the top. Nettle, we've got. Let's just check that. It's a requirement. We've already got it installed, so it must exist. Again, we can check for these binaries. The binaries are in bold. So there's three there. Yep, that's right. So makeCA, libunistring, libtazen, we've got p11 kit, gar, libidn or two. Right, net tools. We haven't got that one. Text live, we've got unbound, we haven't got. Valgrind we've got, and the rest are off the book. So again, we'll just check this. We've got all of these options, so let's start with this one. Unbound, tar, XVF, unbound. So this needs a separate user. Security purposes. And sudo su. Okay, so that's worked. Let's go back to the normal user and configure. Let's see what we've got here. We can have live event because we've got that. And we can add these Python bindings as well. So with live event and with py unbound, just take off that colon at the end. So let's build it. Okay, so that's built. Let's make some documents. Now run make check. So that says test OK. Let's become the root and install the package. Oh, of course, we need to be in BLFS. And we've got the extra documentation here to install. So this is in default configuration, unbound will bind to localhost and allow recursive queries only from localhost clients. If you want to use unbound for local DNS resolution, run the following command as root use. So I suppose that turns it into like a DNS server, so I'm not going to do that. I'll carry on using my own server for DNS resolution. When unbound is installed, I'm not using DHCP, so I'm going to ignore that bit. When unbound is installed, some package builds found, if a file is not found. This file is created by running the boot script. Install instructions below. Alternatively, created by running the following command as the user. Well, let's run it anyway to create it, and then we'll go into BLFS boot scripts and do make install unbound, and we can start it as well. So that's installed and working. Let's tick this one off. Unbound is 23 other server software. So now we go on to NetTools CVS. Let's download this. Save link as, and there's a patch. So it automates the process by piping yes to the make config if you wish to run interactive configuration. So I think we'll just take the default yes that they've provided instructions for. This package has several unneeded protocols and hardware device-specific functions that are obsolete. To only build the minimum needed for your system, skip the yes command and answer each question interactively. Some minimum needed options are Unix protocol family and INET TCP/IP protocol family. Well, may as well do that if there's obsolete stuff going to be installed. I don't really want that. Could possibly be a security hazard. Patch below cleans up the installation so it does not overwrite the ifconfig and hostname programs that were installed in LFS. Okay, so let's extract it. What's it called? Net tools. So we'll run these two commands in. So it says to build, skip the yes command and answer each question interactively. So we'll just run make config. So we only need Unix protocol family and INET TCP/IP protocol family. Unix protocol family, yes, set to default. INET TCP/IP protocol family, yes. So it looks like we answer no to everything else. Generic support. Okay, we'll just say no to everything else. Okay, that's it done. Let's run make. There's no test suite, so let's make install. Looks like that's that one complete. So that's chapter 15. So now we can tidy that up and reinstall GNU TLS. So let's check this. Well, we need to disable Garl even though we've got it because it's not supported by GNU TLS. Which is enable GTK doc we can use without colon. Enable SSL compatibility. Let's do that. It might be useful. We'll need a space there. Without P11 kit, we've got that, and we don't need the included Unistring because we've got the external one we've already installed, so that should be enough for the configure. Oh, hang on a minute. I've just noticed with default trust store, this switch tells configure where to find the legacy CA bundle and to use it instead of PKS number 11 module by default. Uses if P11 kit is not installed. Right, so we need to remove that. Good job of noticing that. So let's remove GNU TLS and extract it again. And yeah, let's bring back the configure. So with default trust store file equals oh no, beg your pardon. So the command is using the PKCS11 option, but it's saying to change that line to cabundle.cert if we haven't got this P11 kit installed, so we have, so the command they've given is correct. Right, it is okay. Yes, it actually says at the top there, it's a bit confusing to omit the one we've put in if P11 kit is not installed, and therefore put this switch in instead with this file. If it's not installed, right, okay, so we've got it right anyway. Let's just check the summary that the configure has given us. So it's not actually using a local uni string. The local one, sorry. Yeah, it's not using the local one, so that's okay. PKCS 11 support, that's okay. Guile wrappers, no, because they're not working. Building something called a Dane library. Okay, that looks good. So let's build it. Okay, and we'll test it now with make check. Okay, so that check has passed, so we can install the package, reinstall it. I'll just check the documentation's been installed. Yes, it has. Yep. So that's okay. So that's GNU TLS installed again. And that's part of chapter 4 security. Find it on my list now. Oh, this was for Wget, that's right. Just look for it. Yeah, that's right, I did have a separate entry, right, so I'm going to mark that separate entry off. And then get rid of that tab and Wget. Yeah, this is the only remaining option for Wget, so we can reinstall Wget now. So, by default, it uses OpenSSL, not the GNU TLS, so well, maybe this is probably an unneeded reinstall for Wget anyway, but I would have installed it with the OpenSSL initially, because when it installed this as a dependency so far earlier on, it was just the three packages we did, Wget, GPM and links. So I'm going to keep the same settings. I don't know what the advantages are and disadvantages of using a different library. There may be some which you might find necessary or useful. I'll keep it as it is. Got Valgrin, so I'm going to enable some additional testing. Not sure if we've got that module or not, so that's something to bear in mind, that some tests may fail. So let's configure it. And I'm going to let's check this output here. GPGMA. I'm not sure if that's a package we could install actually, although it's not in the optional list. Let me look for that one. Yeah, here's one. Let's install that first. Don't think we've installed it, have we? No. Libsuman. Libgpg error. What else does this need? No, we've got everything there. Yeah, I think I'll install that and see if it does take advantage of this GPGME. So I'll come back out of that. Remove Wget. We'll start with libgpg error. Looks like we've already installed this, so that's handy. Let's double check. Yep, we've got one of the binaries there, so we'll get rid of that one. I'll just check that's been marked off. Lib.gpg. Yep, that's marked off. So lib.sun. Okay, we haven't got that one. So there's no alternative options for the configure command, so let's just copy all this stuff. And we've got an option to build other formats of the documentation here, because we've got TextLive installed. Let's finish, let's run make check. It seems to have passed okay. And let's install the package and the software, the software documentation. So that's that one done. That's general libraries as well. So let's do GPGMA. Installing test results. GNU PG installed. I think that's one I've got to install again. Or haven't installed. Oh yes, for libssh, and that needs openssh, so we can do that after this. So let's just check GNU PG. Looks like we might already have, oh no, perhaps not. It's got a load of dependencies. Right, let's abort this build at the moment and concentrate on this. Okay, let's just check we've got libg crypt. 6p dumps. Yeah, we've got that. Okay, SBA and NPTH pin entry. Got curl fuse. Got that one. We haven't got that. MTA, right, we'll need to install that for another package anyway, so might as well do that now. OpenLDAP's the same. Quite a big install that is, I think. And that's not too bad. We've got, oh yes, it needs a couple of databases. So Cyrus Sazzle. Unix ADBC. Mariadb or PostgreSQL. So I use Mariadb. Mariadb, not sure how to pronounce that one. This needs so libaio. We've got all these. Okay, so that's not too bad. So let's go back up all these dependencies. There's libaio. and straightforward. That's very simple actually, rather than straightforward. There's no configure. It's just a make part check. Okay, that's tested fine. Let's install it. And that's done. So that's general libraries. Mariadb, let's download this. So yeah, it's good warning here. Mariadb and a MySQL cannot be installed in the same system without extensive changes to the build configuration of one of the two applications. So Mariadb is basically a fork of MySQL. As far as I know, it remains compatibility with MySQL, but it's like a more open source version. So probably the best of the two from that point of view. So let's extract it. Gzip format, interesting. So does that mean that's going to a different web page probably? Let's save this one instead. That should just be a direct file. Just wait for this to download. It's almost there. Yeah, it's done. Okay, so we've got all the dependencies. Let's start by adding a group and user for MySQL. And then we can start installing. See if there's any extra options. I'll tell you what, let's run these in first. Check the options. With embedded server on, this enables compiling the embedded server library needed by certain applications such as Amarok. So that's on. With extra child settings complex, that sounds good. Skip tests on. Switch disables tests from Mariadb connection, which is not supported by additional setup. Skip tests on, yeah. And without server on, use this switch if you don't want the server or would like to build a client only. Well, on a single machine, a database is not much use without a server, so you probably don't want that. If you had a separate machine with a running server, then you may want that just to connect to that server on a remote machine, but as I say, on a single machine, you probably wouldn't want that in case you do want to do something with the database or another application needs it. So I can't see that in there without server on. Yep, so I think we can just copy this as it is. Okay, I thought there might have been a summary there, but there isn't, so we can just run or time this make to build it. Okay, so that has built. Let's now run the tests. So there's basic tests we can run with make tests, and then there's some more advanced ones, extensive sets. I'm going to run basic ones first, just to get a general feeling for, you know, a general bit of confidence in the package. And then I'll be running the other set of tests as specified here. Successful this set of tests, one test is known to fail, so we'll see how we get on with that. And yes, we did get one failure. Test connect, yep, that's the one that's specified, so that's fine. So now I'm going to do this set of extensive tests, and we have to specify the number of jobs. Here. So I'll just put the number of calls in for, we'll time this, how long this takes, and give that a chance to complete. Okay, so there were some failed tests. We only had two failures. It did say three would fail due to character set issues, but two is obviously better than three. Having said that, it does say there's 3,700 tests to run, when in fact we've had 5,097. So again, this is probably data that's a little bit out of date. And possibly also the fact that the SBU measurement is a little bit out as well, but then they're not particularly accurate anyway. Only really a guideline. So there's no specific mention of which test fail, so as far as I'm concerned, happy to install that. Like install. It's done, let's become the root user again. And running a basic config file for MySQL. Right, you can now install the database and change ownership to the unprivileged user and group form as the root user. Source the etc profile and try the command again. No, it doesn't like that. Okay, that's interesting. Oh, took me one thing I didn't do is pop back the directory. Not that it would make a difference. These might be actually in SBIN properly. How strange. So where did this get installed to? I don't know why this... Strange, it seems like no binaries have been installed. Okay, I'm gonna have to I know why I didn't pop the directory back. That's why. So I need to do sudo make install from this directory. That's why it's failed. That's better. Hopefully I haven't installed anything too strange where I was before. So let's try. Yeah, it's finding the programs now. Purely because I forgot that popd directory is in the wrong direction when I ran make install. So it looks like it only installed some documentation at the time. Right, so let's try this again. Run these two commands in separately. So two all privileged accounts are created. One is root localhost. The other is MySQL at localhost. So run this command to change ownership to MySQL owner as the root. And now we've got to run the server. Got to include that other ampersand to run it in the background. That's gone into the background. And then we need to run this command to set a password for the root. And we can shut down the server now. Put the root password in, and that's shut down. Now we go to the boot scripts, BLFS boot scripts, run make install MySQL, and we can restart the server again as usual. That daemon started, so now I've got this server running. So let's tick that one off, chapter 22. In fact, looking at the chapter list, MySQL is not there, so there's no problems about installing one over the other. There only would be if you specifically went to the website to download it. So let's close that one down and tidy up here.